We need a subroutine to print out what directions we can go. So this will be based on the current room we're at. I don't know what I is. Oh, this is our, this is an iterator. Okay. So we need int map neighbors. The number of rooms. Well, not necessarily, but we can pass that in. Number of directions, and then we need the direction string. String directions. So we'll put this at the beginning over here. And I should make sure I don't have syntax errors. I'm not totally sure if I can convert a const array to a not const array. Oh, also I should possibly include the functions file. Oh, okay. Blub. Well, we're gonna hard code it. I could make it a pointer, but we're not gonna do that. We're gonna say there's 19 and 6. 19 and 6. I forgot some semicolons. So, directions you can go. Oh, that, I turned into a 1 when I did that. That was confusing. Oh, I need the current room also. Okay, so that will give us that part. Okay, in R is number of rooms. Yeah, okay. I'm going to rearrange these so they are in order by line number. Okay. Filling the world. We need swords and books and magic formulas. We must create 3 new arrays. OB is the string of object names. O2 is a string of letter tags. Okay, so those I think are the 3-letter terms. We can make ours a little better than that, but let's go ahead and add it anyway. So string object names. String object tags. And then a room, so int object in room. So NO is number of objects. Number of objects. It's a const int. And so we will need to make a list of everything in the game. Setting up data. Let me guess, this is going to be our setup number 2600, or 26,000, sorry. So we got it, yes, over here. So setup objects. We will have to call it here. We're going to have to pass in all of the arrays, so. And at the end, int number of objects. Might as well make those const, because, you know, they're not supposed to change, especially inside the function. Don't change them. Well, that one doesn't need to change either, because I know that it's not going to change the item from the calling side, but like, if you were a student of mine, you might accidentally try to change those in here. And yeah, not supposed to. Don't change them. Okay. So, let's Are these all of the data objects? I think so. I can just copy these and then we can try to figure out what's going on. Oh, that didn't copy good. Okay, well, we're just gonna have to reference it. So, 6 objects in the list, the cabinet, wooden barrel, and the tree, wooden boat, nasty looking guard, have numbers larger than 127. These cannot be picked up. The guard, for instance, has a room number of 144. Okay, if we tracked 144 from 128, we see that the guard is in room 16. Okay, that's I suppose, a way to do that. If we were writing object-oriented code, I would just make a struct and have a bool, but... Or we could have an array of bools as well. That would make it easy. Because is there only one item per room? No? Well, no, okay. We're just linking to which room they belong in. But we could have a boolean of can pick up object instead of having to do some random ass math. But, you know, we'll stay true to the original logic, I guess. Okay. Should I just set this up like an old... Yeah. All caps. We are in old caps... All caps land, not old caps land. We have 17 total. Or, sorry, yeah, 17. Just to double check. Since these are not using the zero index, we're gonna have to change that. 6 number of rooms. Let me double check. We're gonna have to make that a 20. Does basic start at index 1? No, okay, it has an object number 0. But it's gonna be confusing me the way they do that. You're gonna confuse me. I got my maps based on this number list. Got my objects based on the number list. But we'll go with it for now. If we get an out of bounds error, it'll be one of these. We're just gonna put these object tags in at the end, just on one line, because why not? You can pick up a rub, you can pick up a glow, you can pick up a cass, you can pick up a gua. Pick up a boa. Wait, am I missing something? 17. What is 16? Where did... Wait, that was 16. This one says 17 and 15. So they're getting mixed up too. It's their fault for not just going with a zero base. Okay, what else we got? Reads object data into 3 objects, and that. What is it, baby? Why are you- oh, you wanna get out? Okay, let me open the door. Oh, my headphones don't reach all the way. Okay, let's implement the you can see. Need object names, I assume. Oh, B. Index, I guess? Okay, we'll need the... I haven't set up the object places yet, but... String object names. Int object in room. constant current room. Let's go ahead and also pass in the object tags. Okay, I need to set up the rooms in here before I forget, because I'm definitely gonna forget. Okay, so objects in rooms. Okay, there's that. Let's go do this one. Not that. Where we display what you can see. If object I... Well, maybe it'll do like a Boolean. Like maybe if it's a zero, if we're not in a room, that it reads it as a false. If that, and if 127... Oh, what? I'm very confused. So I think this is here, like, found something is false. Found something is true. If the object in the room is not zero, current room is R, right? I think? Well, I would assume object in room I would equal the current room. So that would be, I think, that logic. So then we'll just output the object names. And maybe I'll also output its tag. That way you don't have to guess at what the thing you type in is, but we'll actually allow them to type in the full name or the short name. Okay. So we got number of rooms, objects, and directions. I guess technically these should be uppercase if we were doing, like, you know, more standard style C++, but whatever. So that is initializing all of these arrays, and then we're setting up all of these. Set up objects needs more information. So object names. Object tags, object in room. Number of objects. Okay. Oh, they have an end line over here, so we'll just do that as well. And I forgot, if found something is false, we'll output nothing of interest.